Ubuntu 19.04 has been released, and you probably already know what's new in this release. But what it means for you as an average Linux user? You will find out in this review. You probably have already seen videos showing you all these new features of Ubuntu 19.04, so I'm not going to stop on them too much. Instead, I would like to show and discuss with you the user experience and performance of Ubuntu 19.04. I will compare Ubuntu 17.10 versus Ubuntu 18.4 and Ubuntu 19.04. Next, we will have a look at Ubuntu 19.04 performance with some benchmark tests. I will also discuss improvements and lacking features of Nautilus File Manager, talk about snaps and why Mark Shuttleworth pushing them so much, and in the end, check Yaru theme and how to enable its dark version. Also, keep your eye on this top right corner. During this video, you will be able to express your opinion on these features by voting there. Ubuntu 19.04 versus Ubuntu 17.10 and Ubuntu 18.04. If you have seen my review of Ubuntu 17.10, you probably know my major complaints about GNOME Desktop in Ubuntu. Most of these complaints are valid for Ubuntu 18.04 and still valid for Ubuntu 19.04. For example, Minimize to Dock is still not activated by default. If you click on the app icon, when it is open, it will not minimize. You have to use the Minimize button. Luckily, you can activate this feature. I show how to do that in my 30 things to do after installing Ubuntu video. Check it out. After the activation, you will be able to minimize an app by clicking on its icon in the dock. Let me know what you think about this minimize to dock issue by voting here. The second complaint is that apps are mixed between desktops. If you move some applications to another desktop, it still stays active on the current desktop. If you choose it, you will be moved to another desktop. To me, this completely ruins the concept of multiple desktop spaces. Fortunately, unlike in previous releases, now Alt-Tab switch works correctly. It shows up only from the current desktop. In Ubuntu 18.04, Alt-Tab mixed apps from all desktops. I also do not like that there is no Show Desktop button, so you cannot minimize all applications at once, while you can easily do it in other desktops. I also did not like that when you click on the activities, you must select any app to go back. Clicking on empty space does nothing. This issue is present since Ubuntu 17.10. Well, maybe it's of course issue of GNOME, but it is still there. Whereas in Plasma 5 desktop, for example, everything works as expected. I click on empty space and all apps go back where they were. The last complaint is a little subjective, but I do not like that the application button is still at the bottom. If you are like me, watch my video on things to do after installing Ubuntu to move this application menu to the top. To me, it is much more efficient location. Of course, it is not fair to only complain. Ubuntu 19.04 brings many improvements too. I have mentioned the Alt-Tab fix. I can also mention that the user settings dialog was laggy in the previous releases. Now it is fast. Actually, Ubuntu 19.04 feels a little faster overall. Not that Ubuntu 18.04 was slow, but some animations like opening the application menu and activities just feels a little snappier. This feeling is actually supported by benchmark tests, as you will see in the next part of this review. Ubuntu 19.04 performance. It is expected that newer Ubuntu performs little better than the older releases. Ubuntu 19.04 indeed has some performance improvements over Ubuntu 18.10. Let's have a look at some of the benchmark. Scientific workload with NAS parallel benchmark, which is a benchmark developed by NASA for high-end computer system. More is better here. X265 video encoding test. More is better here. Timed Linux kernel compilation. This test measures how long it takes to build the Linux kernel. Less is better. Blender test. Blender is a 3D modeling program. Less is better. R benchmark. R is a programming language for statistical analysis and data science. I personally use it at work every day. Less is better. PyBench provides the results of Python average performance on a given system. Less is better. Ubuntu 19.04 is also slightly better in internet browser performance. Selenium is one of the browser's benchmarks. More is better here. Unfortunately, I do not have an opportunity to run benchmarks yet. So I use the results from foronix.com. It is a great website to check the performance of Linux distros and hardware running Linux. So here's a geometric mean of all tests performed by Foronix. Obviously, Ubuntu 19.04 is better than Ubuntu 18.10, but it is behind Clear Linux. Nautilus File Manager. Speaking about speed, I would like to say that Nautilus File Manager has been improved. It is now faster than before. There is also no toolbar anymore. Now all buttons are placed on the title bar. However, all this doesn't overweight the major issue of Nautilus. You cannot set Nautilus to show different view for different folders. If you have your home set to icons view, all other folders also have icons view. If you change the view style of one folder, it changes the view of all folders. You can see the home folder has list view now. Also, it had icons view before. This is one of the main reasons I do not switch to GNOME full time. For example, if I have folder with pictures, I would like to have an icon view. But if it is a folder with many files, I think it is much better to have list view. And I would like these settings to be fixed for each folder. Snaps. Mark Shuttleworth is pushing snaps very hard. In this interview about Ubuntu 19.04, he talks a lot about how great snaps are. And he is right. But all the greatness he described is primarily related to the application developers and not the end user. Let me show you an example. Right after the installation, Ubuntu suggested me to install some popular apps. I installed Audacity, because I use it to record audio for my videos. When I opened it, I was surprised and maybe shocked a bit, because this is how Audacity looked. And I knew Audacity looked fine in Ubuntu 18.04, which is installed on my computer and I use it occasionally. It did not take me long to realize that the version Ubuntu suggested me was a snap version. As you can see, there are two Audacity apps available in the Software Center. When I installed the second one, it appeared to look normal. So, snaps is a great concept. It helps to avoid dependencies mess for developers, but the end user doesn't care much. The end user sees this. A snap version and a regular version. Guess what he or she will choose. By the way, this is a problem not only of Audacity. I use it as an example. Snaps apps can look good. For example, such pre-installed apps as Calculator, System Monitor, Logs. I do not see the reasoning to use snaps for this application, but they look fine and it is okay. According to Canonical, more than 2000 software publishers now distribute applications as snaps. This is very encouraging, but until this theme issue persists, I doubt many users will use them. Yaru Dark Theme. Yaru Theme, formerly known as Community Theme, is a really nice theme. I covered it together with other Ubuntu themes in my Ubuntu themes video. That video is still valid for this version of Ubuntu. If you want to change your desktop theme, go and watch the instructions there. So, Yaru Theme now covers more applications. I would say it is a complete theme now. I was not able to find any missing icons, unlike in previous version of Ubuntu. Great job on that. However, you cannot change this theme by default in Ubuntu. Nowadays, it became a standard to have both light and dark themes pre-installed. But in Ubuntu, to enable a dark theme, you need to install GNOME tweaks and enable the dark theme. But it brings a small problem. Pre-installed snaps look bright and light. To make a conclusion from this Ubuntu 19.04 review, I would like to say that you can upgrade or install Ubuntu 19.04 if you suffer some serious issues with your hardware performance right now. Otherwise, it is not worth upgrading. Actually, I think in some sense it can even hurt you. For example, if you want to use dark theme or some custom themes. AllSnaps apps will not look good. By the way, you can check how to enable some custom themes in Ubuntu by clicking on some of these videos you see right now on your screen. Thank you for watching!